On his own. No, it's me. Sorry. I'm going to say right up from the top, it's going to be interesting tonight. Things that, what is it? Is it Murphy's Law? If something can go wrong, it will go wrong. I feel like Donald Trump on the edge of an election victory. See, that's my only topical joke. That's the only topical joke that I'm going to do today. Thank you so much for joining us here on our circuit breaker. It's our second day of lockdown, isn't it, in the UK? We've got people all around the world coming into their hen house tonight. We have people from over there and people from over there. I'm saying that because I forgot their names. I usually have a list of the people that are coming in to do the show tonight. And the list is not up yet, so we will come to it. We will be playing stuff. Oh my goodness, I'm not even straight onto the. That's better. And I don't know if you can hear me. I don't know if the music sounded any worse or better. I'm sure that if people can hear me properly, they'll give me a little wave underneath that it's everything's all good. No, they're not. They don't. Can't hear me. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, Av? Wave. Yeah, good, James. Can you hear me? Yeah, that's good. He's good. That's good. People out in the internet. Can you hear me in the internet? Can you hear me? Can you see me? Right, that's excellent. We've lost two viewers in my little monologue there. That's fine. I don't mind. I haven't even started being funny yet. So, do me a favour. As you're watching this now, can you share the stream? Share the stream. Just if you're watching on Facebook, it's easier. I tell you that for nothing. Good. So anyway, I wanted to tell you that last week I told you that I was going to go to the doctors, and but I didn't go to the doctors because the doctor came to me via the beauty, the magic of Zoom, right? And I had to take my wife. Please to the doctors the other day, and I told him that it stings Roxanne every time she does a wee, right? He said I should move my face out of the way or wear swimming glasses. Also, she stopped putting anchovies in the pizza, so that's all right, isn't it, really? Yeah, I'm still waiting. Oh, we got comments. That's what I was waiting for. Please leave a Oh, Bianca. Now, I know, because he's been tagging you in all the posts. Nice to meet you. Thanks for leaving a comic, and thank you. Comic, and thank you for saying that I sound great, because I believe that I do sound great. I really do sound great. That's the thing. So we've got some great people here tonight. I've forgotten all their names. It's unbelievable. I wanted to talk about... something else, but I can't get this thing to work. I have this thing, right? I've got a thing. Maybe if I just reset everything. I told you, tonight is going to be a night of horrors. Horrors, it is, apart from the axe, because the axe will be doing their bit, and that'll be great. So, yeah. I wanted to talk to you about the gym. You know, in Liverpool, I think, was it Bedford? This guy's leaving his gym open because he thinks during lockdown it's fine to go to the gym because being healthy keeps the Rona away. And I understand that. The healthier you are, then obviously it's going to be better for you. But he did actually blame. He was saying he was staying open because it was important for people to be healthy, and that fat people, if they get the Rona, they're going to die quicker, right? Which is, you know, I suppose that makes sense. But, like, he says obese people. He's staying open for the obese people. He's not staying open. I'm obese. Oh, well, I'm not obese. My wife says I'm a beast. But, no, I'm fat. I'm very, very, very fat, right? But I'm not obese, but I'm very, very fat. And I'll tell you something, being very, very fat, the last place I ever want to be is in a gym. So, you know, don't keep it open for me, mate. I'm fine. I'm fine staying at home with me mask on or me swimming goggles. Right, we've got three comedians here. We've got Samantha Day in the Henn House tonight. Samantha Day. Samantha Day in the Henn House tonight. There's a joke in there somewhere if you want to look for it. If you don't want to look for it, then that's fine. I'm coming into big screen now so I can see myself. I keep doing this with my jacket and I don't know why I'm trying to stop it. It's a dirty, dirty habit. I'll tell you another dirty, dirty habit, and that's a Franciscan's habit in a mud puddle. 1984, that one. Right, I think I've got another 2 minutes to talk until we go and play What's in Av's Box. Last week, Av had a rolling pin in his box. My goodness gracious me. I wonder what that was there. I looked behind me because I thought someone was behind me, but I'm expecting something from Amazon. I think that's here. Let's take a little break. To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, give them some money. They're fucking funny.
Please donate to our comedians tonight. Just one cup of coffee would make the difference.
Donate now at buymeacoffee.com/magic or support comedy at either bit.ly or paypal.me. And don't forget, scan the can during the show.
Seriously, just a bag of chips will help.
Scan the can, don't be a twat and scan the can.
That was all right, sorted that out. I just had to, they don't sign for it anymore. They just chuck it in front of you, ring the doorbell, and then they're off. But that's all right. Lockdown. Okay, the time of night has arrived. It's time to go and see Av sing.
It's an orange, it's a carrot, it's a rabbit, it's a cock. What's Av got in his box?
Hello.
Hello, Av. How are you?
Oh, I'm all right, I suppose. All right. I had a bad week.
You had a bad week? What happened, mate?
You know, people are inconsiderate bastards, ain't they?
I'm going to,
especially now, go to work. I have to go to work, right?
Okay, all right, well done. Show off.
I know. Get to the car park. Some inconsiderate bastard has parked over the bay lines. So only one spot left, so I've got to try and park the car. As I'm parking, my tyre hits a bollard and rips it open.
No.
Yeah, 170 quid.
Fuck, go, no, go, oh, no, for a tyre?
Yeah.
No.
To come out and fix my tyre.
£170 for a bit of rubber? That's terrible. I mean, 170 quid would feed a family in Redditch for a year.
2 years in that country.
Hey. Yeah. That's a lot of money, though, isn't it, for a tyre? Yeah, so is that what pissed you off?
What do you think about my tyre? Freaking lockdown, yeah? Pandemic, Boris, furlong, Rishi, kicking the balls.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense, mate. It actually does make perfect sense.
It shouldn't, though, but it does, doesn't it? It does.
it does make perfect sense. That's all right. Are you excited about the election, the big Donald Trump debate?
Yeah. You know something? That's another thing that's pissing me off. Yeah. Apparently, right, Biden has just got to win Transylvania.
No, not Transylvania. It's Pence. 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 Pence.
Trans?
Pence.
Trans?
No, Pence. Pence.
Pence is trans. I know he looks like an old lady, but I thought Republicans were like anti-trans, weren't they? And Democrats were like pro-trans.
You did that, didn't you? You did that just so I fed you that. It's trans. It's Pennsylvania, not trans Pence.
Oh, sorry. It does look ask the audience. He looks like an old lady, doesn't he, without any makeup?
Hey, people, does Pence look like an old lady? Valerie Apperson's in the house! Woo! I'm leaving on that midnight train to Georgia. Woo-hoo! Come on, Georgie, now you can do it.
That's an old reference, isn't it? That is. How old are you, Steve? I'm too young to know that one.
It doesn't make me old, just because I know classic songs. I sing a bit of Mantovani, doesn't make me old.
But you did a we call it 70s music show, didn't you?
Yes, we do the 70s music, me and David Luck, every week on a Sunday, thanks very much, 9 o'clock, Luck and Hen. We had the police on this week.
Oh, the police. I hate Sting.
Why? Why do you hate Sting?
He's always banging our elf years, does all this yoga, yeah. And apparently, it's him saying this, yeah, he can have sex for 7 hours.
That's nothing. I've had sex for 7 hours. If you count up every time I had sex in the last 4 years, it comes to 7 hours, plus a couple of sock times as well.
That's too much information, Steve.
Is it? Okay. Right. Shall we play what's I've got in his box? No? Do you want to not play what's in your box?
Yeah, let's play.
Things carrot in a box.
Okay, carrot. No, we've done that.
I can't get over that.
What? Nor can I these days. So, right, I'm going to ask the same three questions just to help people. Right, what have you got in your box? Is it animal?
No.
Is it vegetable?
No.
So it's mineral?
I'll just say yeah, because I don't even know what class is a mineral. But yeah, it's a mineral. It's an object. Right.
It's an object of my desire. There you go. Thanks very much. It's Av. Say goodbye, Av.
Goodbye, Av.
Av sings carrot in a box.
Wow, look at that. I'm so good technically that I forgot to do that before I did that. And then I forgot to do that as well. And now I'm going to do this and say hello to James. Hello, James. You all right, mate?
I'm squeaky clean for this family show here.
Did I ever say it was a family show?
You never did.
No, that's all right then. So how are you? I haven't seen you for a while.
Yeah, it's been months. It's been seasons. It's been an election. The world almost ended. It's hanging on by a Transylvania right now.
That's right. It is. It's a few votes off a, well, I don't know what it is really. So, I was going to ask you a question, and I don't know what that question was. So
something about a box, maybe?
No, you can do your bit, and then you can play with Av afterwards in his box. But don't ask any rude questions. He hates the rude questions.
Well, you know, there are no universal rude questions.
That's very good. Oh, I know what. Whereabouts are you? That's what I want to know. I keep telling everyone.
Right near the state that is going to decide the election, Transylvania.
You're near Transylvania. No, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, no, I lived in Pennsylvania. I lived at the first time I voted was in Philadelphia when I was 18. Actually, I voted for Gore. Of course, my first vote didn't count, and it still doesn't to this day.
Oh, can you vote? Could you vote by whatever they call it?
Yeah. Absentee.
That's the one. Oh, well, that's what we do. That's what we do in the United Kingdom. Absentee. Yeah.
So, have some tea.
Have some tea.
Oh, I see what you did there. Wordplay.
Thank you very much. I try my BEAST. Now, listen. Yeah. No, you're in Transylvania, aren't you?
No. I am in Romania. Transylvania is a region in Romania that Hungarians have been trying to claim for years. They have a whole organization devoted to it, Hungary for Blood.
Oh, my. Hey, that's good. Hey, I'm so glad you agreed to come back, and I'm looking forward to your... I hope technically you'll be better than I am. Ladies and gentlemen.
We'll see. I don't know if that's possible.
Back in the hen house. It's the wonderful... What's your name again? James Long?
Is it my set now? Wow. Okay, hello, everybody. I just zoomed in from Bucharest, and boy, are my jokes tired. Hello, Hen House. Are we having a clucking good time or what? Let's have another round of applause for our host, who is no ugly duckling. No, he is a beautiful white swanel, Steve Swanel. Woo! Steve, you know, I agree with you. Murphy's Law really is coming back in style. It's like I'm always expecting the worst these days, and then it happens. So, like I said, I'm zooming in from Bucharest, but I'm from New York City, the London of America. I use that one on, I do a lot of virtual comedies all over the world, and I use that one on every stop on the tour, like a rock star. Like in Russia, I'll be like, I'm from New York City, the Moscow of America. And the Russians are like, yet. And then they throw a bottle of vodka at me, but, you know, it's Zoom, so their loss. I grew up in New York City with three sisters. They were a coven of bitches. Witches! Witches! I don't need to censor myself. This isn't a family show. So bitches. Bitches, yeah. I'm sorry. Please, you know, forgive me. I'm suffering from PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. I'm taking pills. Not for that. I'm just taking pills. So, we had some things in common. We did. Like, we all have long blonde hair. None of us had tits. And we all know the lyrics to Spice Girls. Ziggy, ziggy. You like that? You like that? That's three sisters, baby. That's three sisters. Actually, I don't know if you like that because there's this at the hen house, you can't hear the audience, but it helps me with solving an important question that I have as a fairly new comedian, which is how long do you hold for laughter when there isn't any? Happens more often than you would think. So I like to think that I was the glue of the family. I helped my sisters bond over hating me. Nah, I kid. I kid because I love those Spice Girl choreography routines. They were super fun. I was Dorky Spice, if you want to be my lover. I'm guessing the answer to that one is no. So I had to get away from the coven of witches, bitches, whatever you want to call them. Whatever you want to call them. And so I ran off to Hollywood to pursue my dream of being an actor. A working actor, and I am living proof that dreams can come true. Yes, my dreams of working with Julia Roberts came true. Let's see, what were my lines? How would you like that steak cooked? And can I get you another cocktail? My performances, I got good reviews. I did. Kanye West tipped me $80 and some weed. Yeah. Still didn't get my vote for president, but only because he wasn't on the ballot in my state. It's not easy to get a job in a restaurant in Hollywood. It's very competitive. So it's viewed as a career. And at the interview, they say, where do you see yourself in 5 years? Winning an Oscar, getting rich and famous, not working here. But you can't say that. So it's a managing team leader. Did I get the part? Did those acting classes finally pay off? It's hard to make it as an actor in Hollywood. It's hard to make it as a waiter in Hollywood. So I packed my bags and moved to Rollywood when my beautiful Romanian wife mail ordered me. I'm just kidding. She didn't mail order me. She female ordered me. It's just a fact. you know, last time I was here, I told you a little bit about my wife. We're still together, so that's good. Things are going well. My wife is making most of the money in the family right now, and so I'm able to pursue my dreams of stand-up comedy on Zoom. Yes, ever since I was just a little boy, I've dreamed of Zoom comedy and Henn House with no laughter. Okay. anyway, but all of this is made possible by wife privilege. Isn't that nice? You know, I told my mother that joke. Actually, she's able to watch me on Zoom. That's one of the blessings of COVID. And she gave me a review. She says, James, I love that joke about wife supremacy. Thanks, Mom. I do. I call her once a week for new material. I do. Well, my wife likes to say, nobody understands me. Well, I'm nobody now, but I'm going to be somebody someday. And then she can say, somebody understands me. But I don't always understand my wife. She speaks six languages. And she is very sweet. She the other day I said, Bianca, we have to find some time for sex. And she says, well, there's got to be 2 minutes somewhere. You know what my mom said about that one, just about that 2 minute sex joke. Wait for it. She says, your father and I really relate to that joke, James. Sometimes I don't even know how we even had four children. Yeah, so my wife and I are very different. Like, I'm ketchup, she's mustard, but somehow we still relish each other. Last time I was here, I also talked about how bad Americans are at geography, how bad they are at geography. So, but I didn't talk about the Brits. And since this is a UK show, I thought I'd do a little Brit roasting, you know, because they're like the Americans of Europe, except they're not, because they Brexited. They're idiots. Just kidding. I can't tell here, but I can always tell with a live audience, you know, the Brits in the audience, because they're the ones who are not laughing at these jokes. But I love you guys. I do. I couldn't resist, you know, wordplay. We love wordplay here. British idiots, Britiots. It was just too delicious. I love you guys. I just love wordplay more. No, but seriously, like, I went to London last summer, and I did an open mic, and I told this joke about Romania, people thinking Romania is in the Middle East, and dead silence. Kind of like right now. You don't happen to have any cricket sounds there, Steve, do you? No, audience was like, well, it is, isn't it? And then I had this conversation twice. Where do you come from? Bucharest. I don't even know what that means. No, a lot of Brits do come to Romania and to get drunk, not because the alcohol is cheaper, but because it takes a lot less to make our girls look good. Sorry, guys, like Romanian girls' pinky is hotter than all five Spice Girls combined and Dorky Spice. So I just need to know one thing before I go. One thing, you know, is Britain still great? Do we need to make Britain great again now that we're done with America? Anyway, I've gone way over time, and I'm union, so it's expensive. And I wanted to tell you about being an actor in Rollywood, what I learned about vampires. So you got to have me back soon, Steve. And you've been a great audience, I guess. Good night.
Hey! They loved you, James, in the house.
Oh, fantastic.
No, it is difficult. It is difficult without having any of that feedback. But you did very well. I was laughing.
Great.
And I do have a video of Tumbleweed, but it would have interrupted your show.
Which is better.
And Bianca, is that right? Is that how you say it, Bianca?
Yes, the one and only.
Gee, that's sweet. Right, so what were you drinking there? I missed that.
I am drinking Pepsi's leading competitor.
Ah, bit of Coke. Ah,
yeah. Dab.
Yeah, when I like
it. Tea when you're having tea.
Tea, no tea. I like a bit of Coke before my tea. It's nothing, nothing wrong with that. Hey, are you ready to play What's in Av's Box?
I was born ready, baby.
Born ready. Here we go. Then we're gonna play What's
Av sings Carrot in a Box.
Oh, almost perfect. Hi, Av.
Hello. How you doing?
I'm doing well.
All right, James. Can I just say first off, you know. You're hyper, you're very intense. I'm just surprised during the pandemic you can get your hands on cocaine.
It's a special recipe.
Yeah, I know. It must be bloody expensive, but if you can get your hands on it, you know, have a few lines.
Why not? Well, I mean, what's not to celebrate right now, you know?
I know. It's great. It's fantastic, isn't it?
We had a party like it's 1999, people. We really do.
I live my life like it's 1999. Right, yeah. I'm going to leave you two to it. You two to it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to see if I can do it twice. Nope.
I know. Oh, there you go. You ready, Steve? You ready, James?
I'm ready, Freddy.
All right, so it's three questions and a guess.
Okay, I ask you three questions?
Yeah, you ask me three questions about what's in my box.
All right.
And then you get one guess.
All right. Are they like yes or no questions or like you can answer freely?
I will elaborate if I need to.
All right.
Okay.
Is it like electric, you know, does it need power?
No, it doesn't need power. It's not electric.
All right. Is it edible?
No, it's not edible either.
Oh, boy. Okay, so not edible and not electric. What is the most piercing question I can think of right now? Is it fragile?
That is a good question. You would like to keep it, how can I say, indoors.
Okay, so...
If that helps.
Okay, so it is a indoor item that does not need electricity and is not edible?
Yes.
I'm going to say a cat. Is it a cat? A pussy?
Let's stick to cat. It's not a cat.
Av sings Carrot in a Box.
Wow.
It went from 15 to 18 very quickly.
It certainly did. I have got something in a corner. I should have put this on, really. I should have put that on. Right. Oh, I'm off. Right. Hey, James, thanks very much. Let's say goodbye to Av. Bye,
bye,
Av.
Pleasure.
See ya, Jane.
James, I hope to see you before Christmas, but if you not will. We can see you after Christmas. I don't know. Annette, hi. Annette's here, so that's cool. Bye. So James Longshore, ladies and gentlemen, follow him, search him on Twitter and Facebook and everything. Nice to see you again, James. Take care.
Yeah, you too.
Bye, James. Oh man. Well, it's going as well as can be expected tonight. That's all I can say. I could say a lot more. Thank you so much for watching. I don't know what that is, really. Why? I thought I'd taken my automatic... I've got webbed fingers. I'll be blooming leaving the White House in 79 days if I'm not careful. Right, so who's next? Oh, yes! It's Mahesh! Ah, let's say hello to Mahesh. Hello, Mahesh. Is that right? Have I got your name right?
Yes, you did.
Excellent. Hey, you're in my room.
I've actually got a green screen, but it doesn't work so well, so I can't do a stage. I have to do living room.
You're in my room.
I have to do your room.
You are in my... What are you doing in my room? What?
I'm a transparent burglar. Does that even make sense?
Hey, a transparent burglar. I don't know what that means, but it would be the name of my next album.
I like it.
That's good. So like me, you're in Los Angeles by the look of your apartment.
Yes, in Beverly Hills.
Beverly Hills. Hey, fantastic. I went to school with Beverly Hills.
Oh, you did? Okay.
With Beverly Hills. I went to school with Beverly Hills and Sandy Lane.
Nice. I like that.
Thanks very much. I can ping anything out of the 70s and make it funny. So no, but you're near Elephant and Castle, is that right? Or Swiss Cottage?
I'm in Swiss Cottage, yeah, North London.
Hey, that's good. How is North London for lockdown?
Very exotic, what can I say?
I don't know.
it's a different world compared to the rest of England.
Hey, thanks so much for doing this, Mahesh. I'm gonna rush into you because I am talking too much tonight. So thanks so much for doing that. We'll see you after your set to play What's in Ours.
I've got noise, by the way. Can I play my I've got laughter.
I've got, if it's as good as mine, there you go. Thank you so much. Hey, well, let me introduce you and we'll see you on the other side for What's in Ours Box. Ladies and gentlemen, Kilnani. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, first time in the Hen House, we have Mahesh
Thank you so much, Steve. And thank you for all who's performed tonight. It's been a great show. Hopefully I don't let you guys down or make it better. Who knows? It's kind of weird. No audience, but it's kind of like doing this in front of my mirror anyway. So I'll start with this. Does anybody else find it weird stealing office supplies, you know, when working from home? I found that funny. Here you go. Wait. Thank you so much. I'll let the laughter die down. There we go. So does anybody else, here's another question. So does anybody else find it weird? Does anybody else, is anybody else worried about the fact that there's 0.1% of germs that hand sanitizers can't kill, right? Like, I'm worried about that 0.1% of germs. Right? What the fuck are they made of? Was that didn't do so well, did it? Yeah, I thought it was mine. So where are we at right now? We're in lockdown part two. That's where we're at. Right? And like most sequels, it's never as good as the original. this lockdown isn't as good as the original. It's like a more watered down version of it, right? Like, you know, do you remember the original lockdown? Like, there was like mass hysteria. Like the world, it was like the whole world was in lockdown at the same time. You know, there was the crazy shopping. I don't know, there was no vehicles on the roads. People took it really seriously. Like the first lockdown, people took it super seriously. The sun was shining. And I feel with this lockdown, the kind of novelty's worn out and people just don't give a shit. So they're doing whatever. And that's the thing, right? Like, I feel that if you're going to do a lockdown 2.0, there should be an upgrade with some serious updates. Right, we should have gone to like third world level of lockdown. Do you know what I mean? Like where the police are just roaming the street with fucking guns, right? They're like, oi, you, if I can come out of your house, I'll fucking shoot you. That would be bloody crazy. Like proper India style, right? Like they get the bats and just beat the shit out of you if you break lockdown. Now that's the kind of lockdown we need. And like I said, I make myself laugh. But that's the thing, right? I feel the government is losing control. And this pandemic, or should I call it plandemic, is all about gaining control. So I feel that government is trying to find new ways, more subtle, more sly ways of gaining that control back. Do you know what I mean? Right? Like when you're browsing the net, surfing the net, is that too old a term, surfing the net? Yeah, when you're browsing the internet, right, you get these messages that just say, like, do you want to accept cookies? Like, you never read anything else, but just accept cookies, right? And you think to yourself, cookies. That's a nice edible treat. I'll accept that. But no, what you don't know, that means that the government can invade your privacy and they've got the control back. That's right. They can send you adverts that that actually apply to you. And you're like, what the fuck? Like, I didn't know they were into that kind of, I didn't know that they knew I was into that kind of toy. Yeah, that's the government for you. So speaking of ads, I'm sure everybody's watching more daytime TV. Well, I'm definitely watching more daytime TV. Does anybody else realize that there are more ads now on daytime TV about life insurance for the elderly and cremations? I'm like, come on, you have to give it to those companies, right? They must be sitting around the board in a board meeting going, all right, listen, yeah? Like, this is the perfect time to fucking take advantage of what we've got, right? The perfect time. Let's just fucking advertise like crazy. Taking full advantage of the situation. What can I say? But speaking of ads, right? Actually, before I get into that, I'm just going to say, not speaking of ads. Speaking of, the elderly. Like, the virus actually, it actually hurts the elderly more than, you know, anyone else. It really destroys the elderly community. And that's the thing. The group of individuals that I'm scared most now of are young white people, right? I'm not being racist, but young white people scare me because this virus, like, it just fucking goes through them like a bloody laxative, right? They don't feel this shit, right? In one hole, out the other. And if you're a colored individual of of any age, you're pretty fucked. going back to the concept of death. Right? I know it's pretty bad, but yeah. Dark comedy, folks, dark comedy. New material and dark comedy. I've never done dark comedy, so for me, this is kind of new. did you know this, that you can only get, I can't do this. You can only get married if one of you is dying. So only deathbed weddings are allowed, right? So one of the partners in the wedding, in the marriage, needs to be dying, right? And the thing is, only 6 people are allowed at the wedding. However, at a funeral, 30 people are allowed. That's right. You know where I'm going. So what you do, right, to maximize output, right, get more for your money, is you do the wedding on the day you know the individual is going to die. Oh man, this is bad. So like that particular day, like as the wedding is commencing, the individual dies and then it automatically turns into a funeral. Thus 30 people more can come in, making it 36. Much bigger event. More for your money, folks. More for your money. Oh man, that just felt bad saying. Actually, it felt funny and bad. I'm still going to continue with the whole dark theme. So so did anyone read about this recently? A 23-year-old girl got a job, finally, after 280 rejections, right? The poor girl got 280 rejections. You know, when I read that, I felt really sorry for her, right? You know, she couldn't quite make it. She couldn't quite hit that 300. Man, that's bad. 300 rejections. What can I say? That is bad. That's pretty bad. I've done that. That's happened to me. But speaking of reading, I'm doing, you know, these days, I'm doing a lot more reading, you know, being isolated. And I spoke to my friend the other day. I was like, so are you doing a lot more reading as well? Now he goes, nah, bruv. I'm doing a lot more weeding. I go, what? He goes, yeah, you're doing reading. I'm doing weeding. I go, that makes sense. You know, a book, marijuana, same level. So let me that, actually that kind of gives me a good way into getting to more cheesy jokes. I think the dark comedy was it was pretty bad. So I'll get to more cheesy jokes now for you. So my ex-girlfriend, she's a beautician, or she was a beautician, and she lost her job during the original lockdown. And when the lockdown eased, beauty salons started opening up. She started applying for more jobs, right? Got 280 rejections. Now she started applying for more jobs and she got an interview. And I was like, awesome. And I called her up days after the interview and asked her how it was. And she said to me, oh, it was shit. It was terrible. Worst interview I ever had. Turns out though, she fucking nailed it. Oh, come on, I love that one. I'm going to give this to me. Thank you. Thank you, I'm gonna let the laughter die down. Okay, yeah, and I like that joke. So, everyone remember the 10 p.m. curfew, right? As if it was that long ago. And during the 10 p.m. curfew, a restaurant opened up, a brand new restaurant. Worst time for a restaurant to open up, but brand new restaurant opened up, right? And I said to myself, yeah, screw the curfew. I'm going to enjoy myself. I'm going to go to this new restaurant. So I went there, right? And I'll give you my review. It was food, amazing. Ambiance, excellent. Service, immaculate, right? Have to admit, though, I did have my reservations. God, I like that one. Excellent. You may let the laughter die down, yeah. So I'm going to end on this. So another big thing during the original lockdown was exams, right? I felt for kids, right? I felt for the youth, with A-levels and GCSEs, because, you know, they had the results had to be U-turned because it was the original ones were horrendous. And that's the thing, like, as a kid, it's hard enough, right? Especially with parental pressure. I remember when I was a kid, like, my parents were hard on me. I remember my dad said to me, he was like, I never, ever want to see a B on any of your exam results. And guess what? He never did. He saw all C's. That's right, all C's. Thank you. I'm lying. I actually did quite well in my GCSEs. I actually got one C. And I'll never forget when my dad found out I got a C, right? He looked at my exam results and he was like, oh, you got a C in Spanish, right? He goes, come over here. He goes, ¿dónde está my belt? And he beat the shit out of me. Proper third world lockdown style. That's what I'm telling you. He went to school on me. Thanks a lot. You've been a great audience.
So I've turned my mic down. You can hear me now. There you go. Mine's bigger than yours. So thank you so much. Mahesh, are you ready to play What's in Ab's Box?
I am.
Have you been listening to the answers, the questions, the I don't know what it is. I don't know. I have no idea what this game is. But here we go.
It's an orange, it's a carrot, it's a rabbit, it's a cop. What's that cop? In his box.
Oh, I could have got that right.
Hello.
Couldn't I? That's the thing I forgot to do.
How are you doing? Steve, now before you go,
Who?
I'm in your living room.
Thank you.
Steve, before you go, can I have a quiet word with you? Just wait 1 second, Mahesh. Steve, come here.
Yeah.
Come a bit closer. I don't want Mahesh to hear this. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
I thought we agreed you only have one funny Indian on.
Yeah. And I'm looking for him, Av.
Av is the token. I shouldn't be on this, right?
I don't agree with tokens.
only cash.
Yeah. Hey, look, I've got an idea. Look, do you know how to play, Mahesh?
No, I don't. Sorry, I haven't been following this.
You've got three questions and then a guess, and you've got it to do it in a minute.
Sure.
All right, so Mahesh, what we've had so far, it's not a cat.
Yeah.
Right? And it's, what did I say? Not a cat. I can't remember what the other thing was, but you got three. Ask me three questions, and then a guess. Okay.
So any three questions
related to what's in my box. Not any three questions. Don't ask me like, are you married? All right.
Okay. Yeah. Is it made out of? Okay. Is it made out of bricks?
Bricks.
Or is it made out of material that we can? I'm getting. Okay. Is it made out of? Soft material.
No, I wouldn't say it's not hard, and I wouldn't say it's soft either.
Okay, is it a creature?
No, it's not a creature.
It's not a creature. Is it a toy?
No, it's not a toy. You got to guess now what's in the box.
It's not a toy, it's not a picture. It's a jewelry.
Oh, sorry, Mahesh. It's not jewelry.
I have things carried in a box.
Wow, what an exciting, tense moment that was in What's in Av's Box. I'm going to rewind that later on tonight and play it over and over again. Thank you.
Steve, can I ask you a question?
What? Yeah, no, I was just looking. What?
Now, out of all the comedians, Mahesh is the only one that you put under a time limit. Why is that?
Because I've worked out that I need to be in the shot. So while Mahesh was on, I'm sure he was very funny, I did one of these and then I put it on so then I could do it. Oh, that's the only reason. But if you want an expert answer, it's this.
Well, I'd be very...
So, yeah, thank you, Av. See you later. Bye, Av. Mahesh, thanks so much for being in the Henn House. Have a good week. Bye, Mahesh. That's this one. Thank you. Back in the Henn House. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going all the way to Fran San's Disco. I left my heart in San Fran's Disco. That's a great joke. I'm going to remember that for after. Ladies and gentlemen, in the Henn House for the first time, it's Annette Mullally. Is that right?
Hi. Annette Mullally. How are you guys doing?
Hi, Annette. Oh, bless you. I've got everything wrong tonight. It's one of those nights, unfortunately.
Oh, it's okay. It's Mullally here, and it's Mullally over in the old country. So,
oh, of course.
Take your pick.
I like Mullally. Yes, Mullally.
It's got cachet. So,
hey, I don't know what that means, but yes, it has. It's got some rag. So you're in San Francisco.
I am.
With all the trams and the bridge. That's nice.
Yes, so, we have two bridges, several trams. It's what we're known for.
I bet you know.
A lot of shit on the sidewalks, but, you know.
That could be Redditch.
That's its own. It's its own part of the local charm.
That's the thing. Who's the most famous person from San Francisco?
Oh my God! Probably.
It's you. You should have said it was you.
Nancy Pelosi, for sure. It's not fucking me. Nobody knows who I am.
Hey, they will. They will. There'll be four people in Reddit to the end of the night.
Sure, sure. Oh, well, I got a little famous on Reddit this week, so maybe it's coming.
Hey, that'd be cool. Hey, thanks so much for doing this. Are you happy with the way the election's going?
You know, 4 days of hanging around watching like votes trickle in. Yes, it's been amazing.
I've discovered CNN.
I'm looking forward to the weeks and weeks of court cases coming up. I'm looking forward to recounts. I'm looking forward to impromptu press conferences where fraud is alleged. You know, just it's not going to end anytime soon, dude.
No, it's not. And I worked it out. It's 79 days, I think, till the 20th of January. So
he
could do a lot of damage in 79 days.
Well, the Electoral College has to meet sometime in December, so we have to get some kind of answer by them or we are in a full-on constitutional crisis, which would be fun.
Yeah. But I find it fascinating. I have been watching on CNN and it's like, it's incredible, really. Not many people seem to like him on CNN. They call his children the offspring.
CNN is done with his shit. It's been great. On election night, they were like, Trump says he'll take it to the Supreme Court. Unclear why. No, they've had some great headlines. They're done with this shit.
It's excellent. Hey, are you ready to do your thing in the Henn House?
I am.
Brilliant. Thank you so much. I'm really looking forward to this. Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from San Francisco, first time in the Henn House, it's Annette Tomato.
Hi. Thank you, guys. Man, how is everyone's relationships doing out there during your, what I hear is your second lockdown? Here in America, we've decided just to play it out. So that's been fun. We still have a lot of stuff closed though. It's been great on my relationship. God, it's like monogamy times 1,000. Like I'm sick of my boyfriend, but I'm not allowed to hang out with anyone else. So he's going to have to do. Also, it's been a real strain on my relationship because I discovered during the pandemic that I am, in fact, an extrovert. Yeah, good time to find that out. Apparently, I just had my fill of human interaction before. Now I crave it. Like as a female comedian, I used to spend every night in bars ducking hugs from creepy dudes. If I could go back in time, I would tongue kiss every single one of them. My God, I didn't know how good I had it. I'm at the point of being starved for human interaction that I would gladly go to an orgy. Just for the eye contact, honestly, just to be in a room with people. Otherwise, not a lot of interest in orgies. My sexual skills are the kind that really only survive in a monopoly. They're pretty bad. But yeah, so I went from doing stand-up pretty much every night of the week to not. And my boyfriend has had to give me attention to make up for all of that. Yeah, it's been really rough. I have started following him room to room like a cat, just being like, hey, what are you doing? Oh, working? What's that like? I have been unemployed the entire pandemic. I was unemployed beforehand, but now it's nice because I have an excuse. Actually, I was able to apply for unemployment as an unemployed comedian. So that has been the most money I've ever made from stand-up. Thank you, State of California. but yeah, I mean, it's definitely been rough on the relationship, right? Like me constantly needing a lot of attention. I am very needy, but like, what's he gonna do? Break up with me during the pandemic? So he broke up with me during the pandemic. Yeah, just about a month ago. This is real. He decided that he wants kids, whereas I have dreams. So a little bit of an impasse there. What are you going to do? You know, we were 4 years together. You think the kids thing might have come up because it did constantly. And I was very clear on my position the entire time. But, you know, I'm not bitter, whatever. The good thing about being a woman who doesn't want kids is it's not like you're wasting your womb time. Man, this is so fun without an audience. It just goes so quickly. I did think about the reverse pregnancy trap. You know, usually people in my situation where you're trying desperately to claw onto a relationship go for the pregnancy trap. But that seemed to trap me more in this situation. So, you know, I've thought about it. The idea that I could pretend to come around to the idea and try for a baby while secretly taking birth control. In a few years from now, when I've never gotten pregnant, you know, what's he going to do? Leave me because I'm seemingly infertile? What a monster he'd be. It's very cruel. I'm just kidding. I don't use birth control. We always pulled out. I don't want to fault him for changing his mind about wanting kids. I mean, honestly, who doesn't look around at the world today and think time for kids? Lovely. Here, our skies are choked with forest fires in addition to the pandemic, so it just seems like an extra fertile time. But, you know, I can say I'm doing fine. I am. I'm doing fine. Thank you. I've had a lot of friends come through for me. It's crazy. I've always heard that men don't do enough emotional labor, but my male friends have been there for me, offering to be my rock in this hard time. And not even just my close male friends, you know, who are always there to like help me move, but, you know, male acquaintances, male Instagram followers, just offering to be a shoulder to cry on. It's like I am emotionally unstable and making terrible choices, and they just want to be nearby. It's so sweet. I have started dating. I know it's probably irresponsible to date during the pandemic, but to me, the more irresponsible thing was to break up with somebody during the pandemic, right? Like, honestly, could he not have strung me along for a few months until there's a vaccine? Seems the polite thing to do. But yeah, so I'm out there. I'm starting to date. It's been weird, man. You know, the last time I got single out of a long-term relationship, I was 27. And oh my God, I had so much fun dating. So I'm pretty sure it's going to be the same now that I'm 35. during a pandemic. I got on the apps and immediately they started showing me dudes in their 40s, which like, yo, that's not my age range. I mean, like technically, yes, it is. It's well within what should be the acceptable age range for me to date, but like, it's not. Because the thing is, you know, I may be 35, but I have the maturity and the emotional intelligence of a much younger woman. It has been a weird age. You know, on one hand, I'm getting hit on by 22-year-olds on Tinder, and on the other hand, I literally had a hip surgery last week. Let me tell you, man. Once I had that hip surgery, those 40-year-olds started looking a lot better. This probably isn't an issue for y'all, but I had to pay like $2,000 to get this hip surgery. I do have health insurance, but you know, they like take it. And as I was paying that money, I was like, man, a dude with health insurance looks really good right now. Like, you know what a 22-year-old isn't going to do? Pick me up from the hospital on his skateboard. Mm-mm, doesn't fit. All right. Thank you guys so much. I've been Annette. Let's bring in your host.
Oh, God bless you. I didn't know you had a hip operation.
Yeah, just last week.
God bless you. We're all hoping everything goes all right. I can imagine you on a skateboard, though.
Yeah. No, I've never been on a skateboard. That, my God. And I don't, at this point, I never will. Like, I will break the other hip.
Oh. Well, how long have you got to be on crutches?
Not too long. Maybe another week at most. It wasn't that bad. I didn't do a hip replacement or anything. It was a arthroscopic surgery. So I'm already crutching around with one inside the house. Like, it's not. I'm pretty chill.
Good, good. You just
I'm
made me.
Available to date is what I'm saying.
I'll tell everyone to get on the plane from over here.
We got no restrictions here in Hella Virus. Y'all are welcome.
Of course, that's right. Welcome. Welcome, everybody.
Welcome. Hey,
that's it. Have you been watching Avs? What's in Avs Box?
I saw the last one.
Are you excited that you're going to play? No.
Avs sings Carrot in a Box.
Hello, hello.
Hi, how's it going?
I'm all right. I think, Annette, you summed up pretty much every comedian that does this bit.
All right. So has it already been asked, is it a carrot?
It was a carrot on the first one we did. On the first one we did. So it's not a carrot now.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see. Is it...
Oh, are we starting? I'm going to give you a minute. Here we go.
So are we supposed to chit-chat first? I'm sorry.
No. Go.
So three questions and a guess, Annette. All right.
Okay. So is it... made by... Do these have to be yes, no questions, or can they be more open-ended?
No, I will elaborate if I need to.
Does that count? Bullshit.
You're okay.
Is it larger or smaller than a wallet?
It is larger.
Larger than a wallet. Is it machine-made or handmade?
Oh. Modern day technology, machine made.
Modern day technology, machine made. Damn. Is this my last guess, or I get one more? Like,
you got one more guess, and
narrow
then
narrow it down. Okay.
Or one more question than a guess.
One more question than a guess. Okay. Is it used daily?
Oh, that's a good question. Actually, it can be used daily. Depends on the user.
Is it glasses of some sort?
Oh, that is a good guess. I'm afraid not, Annette.
Oh,
so close.
You'll be able to tell all your friends that you played What's in Our Box and you got so close.
They'll be excited to know.
I'm so excited myself. That's another episode that I'm going to watch later on tonight. So thank you so much, Av. We'll see you later. Bye, Av. And Annette, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
I want you to come back as soon as you can. But I'm booking people into December, so it might be after the holidays. But
yo,
thank you so much.
All right.
Thank you. That's Annette Mulhaney. I've got it wrong, but thank you. Bye-bye. Hey, that was good. I enjoyed that. I enjoyed that loads. Now, we're rushing on to the end of the show. I like rushing on to the end of the show. And we're going to go back to, we're going to see someone who actually appeared live in the flesh at the Palace Theatre when we were doing Hen Nights. And she's back virtually in my hen house. It is, of course, the wonderful Samantha Day. Samantha!
Hello,
how are you?
Steve. I'm happy to be in your little house.
Oh,
when
I
we
am
went
as well.
To the Palace Theatre, I thought I was on the main stage. I never said nothing on the night. I thought I don't want to bring the night down. But yeah, I thought I was going to be like, you know,
that's the only way
size.
I could. It's the only way I could book people. Say, yeah. Come and play. You know, I wouldn't say come to the Palace Theatre.
It's a. And I go, yeah. And then I get there and it's like going that back room. If I could talk to those 10 people. So, yeah.
There was more than 10 people.
There was 20 at least.
You brought 8 of them.
I brought 8, for goodness sake. And you brought another 6. That's 14 before we've even started.
What else do we need? 14 people in Redditch. All right. It's a...
I'm in a funny mood. I'm in one of my
That'll make a change, won't it?
Yeah.
Hey, that's good. So have you been able to do any gigs in lockdown?
Yeah, actually, I mean, honestly, the week before last, I didn't want to brag. I earned £70. 50 plus
no.
20. Yes, I did 2 gigs. And I actually, things were just starting to ramp up towards something that resembled something I remembered from 6 months ago. But, you know, that's not happening anymore, is it? So never mind.
No, it's all a bit. It's all a bit of a shitstorm in a teacup, isn't it? Really,
it's a shitstorm in a teacup.
It's. I don't know. I don't even know where the positives in life are anymore.
I don't know. No.
But let's bring everyone down before I introduce you. How about that? That makes sense, doesn't it?
I think so. Yeah, and it can get everyone in a sort of despondent mood. That's how I prefer it. Certainly.
I think yeah. If you're all despondent out there, can you leave a comment how despondent you are? But if you're,
yeah.
What's the opposite of despondent? Upondent.
Jubilant.
Jubilant. Ooh. Fantastic. Oh, jubilant. Yes. Good. He used to sing a great song. You're beautiful.
Yes.
Thanks.
Yeah, it rhymes with blunt, doesn't it?
So a lot of things do. A lot of things.
Yeah.
Hey, I really want to play this clip, but I'm going to wait to the end, really, because we you never know, it might happen, but it might not.
Are you waiting for the US election to be decided? Are you hoping that during your show you will break the world, the news worldwide?
Yeah, that's it. I've got a video. Shall I play it?
What is it? Why can't the Americans count quicker? I don't understand.
They can't count because they follow their leader. You see, we can't listen to rules because we follow our leader who doesn't listen to rules. So Donald Trump can't count. So therefore, ergo.
Nobody in the country is allowed to be able to count. Okay, fair enough. I understand completely. That's fine.
There you go. Any more questions anybody wants? I am the Oracle. So come on, Samantha. I'm so glad you're here. So, ladies and gentlemen, back at Hen Night's first time in the Hen House. It's Samantha Day.
Hello, everybody. Hello, jubilant people. And how are you? I have started working from home again. And my boss, Gavin, is trying to motivate me over Zoom now. And he tries to motivate me using inspirational quotes. Which is a bit of a shame, actually, because I'm motivated by money. But he will persist. So he says things to me like, Samantha, you need to be the change you want to see in the world. And I'm like, yeah, no, Gavin, how can I be you going under a bus? Doesn't make that much sense. You know, I don't really like change. I like more staying the same because change is effort, isn't it? But Gavin says to me, you know, if you do what you've always done, Samantha, you will get what you've always got. And I'm like, well, Gavin, if you do what you've always done, you've probably got OCD, haven't you? If you do what I've always done, probably got chlamydia. Anyway, Gavin and I had a bit of a misunderstanding. because this week, you know, the sound quality on these Zoom calls is not fantastic. And he thought that I had called him a runt. And I hadn't. I hadn't called him James Blunt either. I'd called him something else. So that was really unfair. And he said he was going to take me to a disciplinary. And I said, well, I am actually into that sort of thing, Gavin. But I think we should agree a safe word first. And it turns out that Gavin's safe word is, I'm calling HR. So then I had to have a meeting with a lady called Mary from HR. And Mary said, oh, Samantha, I'm terribly sorry, but you have not met expectations. And I said, well, the funny thing is, Mary, I didn't actually expect to. So in that sense, I have. And I said, I've not done really clever, really funny things to Mary. But not everyone appreciates intelligence, do they? And I don't have to do any more Zoom calls now. So that's really cool. And I found out after the event, actually, that the most common reason for someone leaving their job isn't, contrary to popular opinion, isn't to go and earn more money. No, it's actually their relationship with their line manager. And I thought, well, that is really weird, because every time I've had a relationship with my line manager, it's actually led to a promotion. So very strange. But not to worry, because I've got what they call a growth mindset. And many of you will know what that is. But for those that don't, a growth mindset just means that I constantly put on weight through no fault of my own. And it also means that I'm always trying to improve. And one of the things which you may not know about me is that you may not deduce this from looking at me, but I was actually the reason that Chris Martin and Gwyneth Paltrow split up. Yes, because my first husband was actually Gwyneth Paltrow. And what happened was, Gwyneth gave me this. Now, you may have seen these. It's a real candles that Gwyneth sells. And it says, this smells like my vagina. So some of you will have seen these. These are about £89 to buy. Now, you normal people, right? If someone had given you a candle like this, you'd have said, Gwyneth, you fucking weirdo, stop it, you're scaring me now, wouldn't you? So not Steve, but you other normal people, you'd have said that. I didn't, you see. I was like, actually, I quite like that, Gwyneth. I like the cut of your jib, I thought. And when I say jib, I mean badge. And the only disappointing thing about this is that it doesn't smell entirely authentic, if I'm honest with you. It smells a little bit of sandalwood. So I first was disappointed, but then I thought, no, Samantha, gap in the market. You must bring out your own candle, which actually smells realistic. So here it is, and I'll be honest with you, I'm going to show it you now. But for whatever reason, it hasn't sold at all well. Only £89, exactly the same as Gwyneth. So I've called it the Fanny Candle. Yes. And I can guarantee that this is, oh, yes. So this smells entirely realistic. And this is made by me at home from entirely natural ingredients. I'm able to certify that. But for whatever reason, I've had a lot of returns of these. And this is actually a return here. And what you'll see from it is, look, they haven't even lit it. You see, it's from people who say they haven't enjoyed it as much as they thought they might, but that, oh, it's actually a little bit damp, so maybe it wouldn't take, I don't know. I just hope that they're not saying that it doesn't smell vaginal enough, because actually, if anything, it smells more vaginal now than when I sent it out, which of course means that I'm able to resell it. Very fine business brain up here. You see, now Gwyneth and I are no longer together because she's very boastful woman, distastefully so, particularly in relation to her cars. You know, near the end of the relationship, she said to me, oh, Samantha, I've got a Prius and I've got a Rolls Royce and I've got an absolutely massive Volvo, she said to me. And that was the end of it, as far as I was concerned. So I don't like boasting. But I've got another husband now, Mr. Day, he's called, And I was explaining to him this morning that I'm going to become a better listener, you see. And if I'm honest, he wasn't paying close attention. In fact, he kept interrupting me quite loudly, quite rudely, just kind of shouting out random words. At one point, I think he said chest pain. He may have said ambulance. At one point, he said nine. Now, he said that three times, you know. Anyway, doesn't matter what he said, does it? The point is, it was very irritating for me. And I just had to remind myself that, you know, it's not his fault. He's just not a good listener in the way that I am. Anyway, that was this morning. The main thing is that this afternoon, he's been a lot better. Yeah, he went to bed around lunchtime and I haven't heard a peep out of him since. That is until this afternoon when I learned, well, this evening actually, I learned that Mr. Day had taken himself out for a drive. And you'll never guess where he drove himself to. The hospital. The hospital. And yet, of course, I had no idea he was even a hypochondriac. So, you know, when something like that happens, it really kind of pulls you up short, doesn't it? It makes you think about what's most important in your life. And it turns out that in my life, it's me. No, I'm joking. I should have gone with him, of course, to the hospital because I might have needed the car later. And we could have called in on my mother on the way to the hospital and that would have cheered him up. He really admires her. How do I know that? Well, every time we leave her house, he always says, that woman is fucking unbelievable. I just think it's so nice, isn't it, when families get on, particularly now we're all locked down together. So I'd like to end by saying, you know, happy lockdown to you and your family. And by all means, buy whichever candle you think will suit you the best. Thanks very much.
There we go. That is very good.
Stop. Thank you. Stop now.
That was. I loved your fanny candle.
Did you? I'm happy to send you one for only £89. Well, you're a friend, aren't you? Let's call it 85.
80. 80. That's so good. That's it. I might buy one for the wife. Although I did buy her one of the. I bought her a fanny candle, and it just got on a wick.
Many women have got whole drawers full of fanny candles if we're honest about it, many of which are never lit.
Please don't develop that with Av. Av doesn't like anything sexual. He likes it clean and clean cut.
Don't worry, my darling, you're in safe hands with me. I shall be as clean as possible.
We don't want to hear anything about a fanny candle, do we, Av?
No, we do not. No. Well, no, Al, I, no more talking no, about it. For God's sake, that's enough.
Can I just say, Sam, I was actually given a gift that smells like Chris Martin's cock. Yeah, it was a jar of Bovril.
Oh.
Was it
yellow?
No, not too much, Dave.
All right, do you know the rules, Samantha?
We will fix you. Yes, I know the rules, yeah.
Okay, cool. No, You've got a minute.
No, I know what they are. Okay.
Do you know the rules?
Yeah, I know the rules. Okay. Is it something which you could wear?
No, it's not something you could wear, Sam.
Is it something that you could utilise as stationery if you needed to?
Oh, sorry.
Could you write on it, for example?
Could you write on it? You say. Yeah, you could. You could write on it.
Could you then put it in an envelope and post it?
Maybe.
Okay, I think I know what it is.
Okay.
I think it's a plastic jug.
Oh, that's a good guess.
It's a wonderful guess. I think the thing to say is, yes, that's right. And you can quickly run to the kitchen, avail yourself of said jug, come back,
and get a jar of
to be triumphant and jubilant like the audience.
Actually, what I was going to say to you, Sam, that's still going to be in my box next week.
Oh, but I think he's going to put a fanny candle in.
Well, they are only £89, should he wish to so do.
Yeah. So
it's not looking keen.
No.
Honestly, the
stop smelling it. Right.
It's hard to overstate. It really is.
Let's bring everybody in for what's in Av's box. Okay.
It's an orange, it's a carrot, it's a rabbit, it's a cock. What's Av got in his box?
Whoa. Hello, people. Okay. Here we go. This is so exciting. We're going to see what's in Av's box.
It's a book.
That's what I said.
And the title of this book is The Zombie Survivor Guide: Complete Protection from Boris Johnson.
Wow, that's excellent. I'm going to say that we've just had a result in from America.
This is a fraud on the American public. This is an embarrassment to our country. Frankly, we did win this election. We want all voting to stop. It's a very sad moment. As far as I'm concerned, we already have won it.
Donald J. Trump.
You're fired.
You're fired.
You're fired.
Yeah, Samantha's gone. Oh, she's back. Yeah, no, that's actually not true. We don't know if that's true. Sorry, Samantha, we don't know if that's true.
I missed that. I lost my connection at the very point when you said I've had a result in from America. I thought it must be something to do with your prostate, but I wasn't sure.
I don't know what a prostate is, but I suppose
I think it's when you lie very flat.
It's either that or a date in future. Hey, though that was a lie, we don't know if Trump has been fired. But thank you, everyone that's been in the hen house tonight. It's your turn to say goodbye to the people watching. Thank you. Say goodbye. Bye-bye, everybody. Bye. This goes on for 2 minutes. You can stay if you want and chat afterwards. But otherwise, you can go. It's up to you. But this is about 2 minutes. Bye, everybody. See you next week in the hen house.
Three cheers for humanity, hip hip hooray, no fears or insanity, we can stop this today. If we're in solidarity, we can make this go away. Stay, stay, stay home, and just let your heart play. Stay, stay, stay home, and just let your heart play, because we're all in this together, hey, yeah. We're all in this together, yeah. Calls for desperate measures, yeah. Let's do what's right and stay inside. Stop the spread, keep up the fight, 'cause we're all in this together. Let's hear it for humanity. We'll see another day. Singing from our balconies to drive the blues away. Yeah. Let's all just put our minds at ease and practice what we pray. Stay, stay, stay home and just let your heart play. Stay, stay, stay home and just let your heart play. Because we're we're all in this.
up the fight, 'cause we're all in this together.